The secret to feeling anything you want or any way that you want is to first of all understand why you're stuck with your current emotional patterns. Whenever you put your attention on something, you get more of it. This is a universal law. And if you are filled with anxiety or depression or fear or anger, and you're saying to yourself, I don't want to feel like this anymore, or I hate this feeling, I want to get rid of it, how can I get rid of it? You're actually just bringing more of it. You're, in fact, locking it into place and making it much more difficult to let it go. You see, when you're saying, I don't want this anymore, you're bringing more attention to it. That's not a step in the right direction, it's actually a step backwards. And many people fail to realize this, and that's why they stay trapped in their emotional patterns that they don't desire. So if you want out, first of all, really become aware of that saying, I need to get out, isn't helping you. The real trick is to take your attention off of what you don't want and bring it into what you do want. So instead of saying, I'm going to quit smoking, I need to quit smoking, I shouldn't be smoking anymore, you know, or I want to quit drinking, I shouldn't be drinking, I'm going to quit drinking. You say, I'm going to start to live a healthier lifestyle. I'm going to choose to take other substances that are actually healthy into my body instead of ones that harm me, right? So instead of trying to quit, you're replacing, you're bringing something new in. And it's the same way with emotions. If you don't want to feel anxiety anymore, saying, I'm gonna stop, I don't want this anymore, how can I get rid of this? You're just amplifying it again. But if you say to yourself, okay, this is the emotion that I want, and you define it precisely, you say, I want to feel happy, I want to feel relaxed, at ease, you know, just joyful, present, right? And you really define what that feels like for you. Now, we're one big step in the right direction. So really, really define, what do I want to feel? How do I want to feel? Maybe drop it in the comments. What emotion would you most like to experience in your life regularly? For me, it's joy, peace, enlightenment, presence, right? So those are my states that I really want to live in. And so I define for myself, okay, well, what exactly do I need to be doing, right, to get into those states? Because it can be very mysterious and mystical. It's like, oh, I want to feel happy. Well, I don't know how to feel happy. So now you're Googling how to feel happy. And that is a whole rabbit hole in and of itself. You don't want to play that game. Instead, you say, okay, I want to feel happy. And then you make a list. What are things that make me feel happy? Things that I do, or people, even, you could list that too. You don't have to just put things. It could be a pet, you know, an animal. It could be a place, that's fine too, but make a list of people, things, places, activities that you do that actually trigger that emotion, that experience, that feeling that you want. And when you have a list, you can start mapping out your week, really just being very strategic, saying to yourself, hey, how can I fit as many of these activities, as many of these places, and as many of these people into my schedule so that I get more of that, so that it inspires the happiness in me to come out. See, trying to feel happy and just forcing yourself to feel happy really doesn't work. If you've ever tried it, you know, because if you're sad and you're like, I don't want to feel sad anymore, I just want to be happy, you just get more sad. Again, that's that resistance and that old pattern, which does not work. So once you've discontinued that and you've realized that's not effective anymore, you put your attention on what you do want to feel, you really define all of the emotions you want to experience, and then you figure out, what do I need to do? Who do I need to be around, right? And where do I need to go to feel that? This is a huge step, because once you have that defined and you've mapped out your schedule and you've said to yourself, this can be overwhelming, by the way, at first, I'm not telling you that this is an easy exercise. This is a little more hefty and more advanced for people that really want to take it to the next level. So if you're one of those people, you know, really put the time in. And then once you have that list, you have that schedule, and now you've tried to fit as much of it into your days as possible, you're going to see that, hey, I'm actually experiencing those desired emotions a lot more. And now that you have all these reference experiences and you have all of this positivity just coming into your life and filling you with joy and all these great emotions, now it's actually much easier. You don't constantly have to keep doing things or being around people to make yourself feel that way, because you see, we as human beings, we get addicted to our emotions and we keep recreating them on a loop. And that's why most people get stuck in the negative one, because we tend to default that way. And it's very frustrating because you don't know how to get out. Now you know how to get out. Now you're in a good one, and you're likely to stay in a good one so long as you don't make this one critical mistake. Okay, this is the one downfall. There is a reason why you experienced anxiety, angry emotions, or any kind of flustering, just dreadful emotions. They come from certain people, activities, and places. You guessed it. So maybe make yourself a little list on that end too, on what not to do. Now, you don't want to bring too much attention here, again, because it could just amplify it and trigger a whole spiral for you. But at least take a little bit of time just to become aware. Who was I around? What did I do? And where was I that triggered me into this anxiety state? Because you're not born that way. Something triggered you. Something happened. Somebody did something, or you did something to someone. What was it? And just take a mental note, or if you really want to get advanced, then write it all down and just know that, hey, this is the stuff that we really want to stay away from, and here's where we want to go, the positive list, if we ever do end up kind of falling down that trail. So really increasing your awareness here, really just understanding why this is happening, why you're experiencing emotions that you don't want, and now understanding and knowing how to create the feelings that you truly desire, the states that you want to experience, and the emotions that you really truly want to feel every single day. They can all be yours. It can all truly be yours. And that good life and that incredible day to day is possible, but you have to be serious. You have to commit to this, and you have to be proactive and not let yourself slip back into the old spiral. I hope that you enjoyed the video. Make sure that you subscribe and turn on your notification bell so that you don't miss a single upload. And if you'd like to experience a real breakthrough and some massive progress in your life, sign up for coaching. It's in the bottom left of your screen right now. If you click on that, you'll go to my website and you can book a free consultation to get us started.